my goal is to not actually do any measurements other than using pi. So the entire thing's gonna be pi-based. We get the circumference in an exact number of pi's, give or take. We get the diameter in a number of pi's. Divide one by the other, we get pi. Pi was historically rarely calculated this way because it's notoriously inaccurate to try and get, I know we're idiots, it's notoriously inaccurate to try and calculate pi by measuring a circle. To get any kind of accuracy on our final answer, we have to be as precise as we can be. This is a mild problem, because I want to go from the very edge of the circle, but as you can see, I've positioned all the pi's exactly on the line, as if they're little mini tangents. So I'm going to have to move these two out, and then I can start doing the diameter exactly on the circumference there, like that. So that's 84 1/3. 264 2/3 pi's around. We know the diameter is 84 1/3 pi. To get pi, we just divide the circumference by the diameter. Okay, and if we actually work out what that is, equals, that's pretty good. Pi, from pi's, we got 3.13834, which is approximately 3.14. So using pi's, we've got pi to be 3.14. I'm a very happy man right now. With the diameter. And if I know that ratio, I can just measure the diameter. That's the easy bit to measure. The center point will be my pen, and the outside will be the chalk. So the pi's, in theory, are a fairly consistent size. So they're all, yeah, they're about the same. Okay.